Hi there, this is Rigo, and today I'm going to show you how can you calculate the volume of a pile of material fast and free. There are two main methods of obtaining this. One is using a manual method, and the other one is obviously using software. I'm going to discuss both here, but first, let's assume that you have a set of cross sections, a file with cross sections like these. So what you do in this situation, you use the average end area method, and that's basically you take the first cross section area, then you average it with the second cross section area, and then you multiply it by the length in between these two. So that's our first cross section. You get the area, you obtain the area, then you obtain the area for this one. You average these two and just multiply it by the separation of in between cross sections. So in this case it's 10. That's going to give you that volume there, and then obviously you do 3 and 4, 4 and 5, 5 and 6, and then you just continue going through the whole section set till you reach the end of the pile here, and then it's just a matter of adding all of them up. That way you obtain the pile volume in total. Another way to do it is if you have a drawing with contour lines for the pile, you can use the grid cell volume method. On this one, what you do is you draw a grid over your pile, and at every inside corner of the squares, in this case, we are going to call them cells, you write down the number of the difference from the elevate base of pile, like 0 to whatever the elevation the contour line is telling you is. Like this one is 1, 2, 3. So you'd write down a 3 there, maybe a 0.5 here, a 0 there, maybe a 0 there. So you average all of them and write down the number here. And then that, you multiply that times the area of the cell. In this case is a 10 by 10, so it's 100 square feet. And then that way you obtain the volume for this portion. Then you do the same thing here, 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 and you just keep doing it all over the pile. So once you're done with it, you just add them up and you obtain the volume for this specific pile. As you can see, these are tedious and long processes. Besides the fact that they're not that very accurate, so let me show you how you can get this volume fast and accurately by using software. The software we will use is called Kubla Cubed. So go to this link and then follow the free download link. Obviously it's going to take you there. Go there and then input all your info and obviously download it, install it, and then let me show you how to use it. Once you have it installed, just load it. Kubla Cube is a software for earthwork volumes. It lets you compare existing surface to proposed surface. The free version, the light version, won't give you much tools to create a proposed surface, but it's gonna give you enough tools to create an existing. So we're gonna switch them. We're gonna work the other way around. We're gonna use the existing as our proposed and the proposed as our existing. Since we just have a flat piece of land around a pile, we don't really need much detail for it. So the good thing of Kubla is that it lets you import files, survey files, DXF files, CSV files, and it even gives you the ability to use a floor plan, I mean a drawing, and it lets you trace over elevations. So the first example, I'm gonna import a CSV file that's a survey file from the pile. So you go to existing, go to ground, then click on the plus, click on feature surface, and it will give you this menu. Go to points, and then to this plus with the cheat to add point files. And then I have one here that's called survey CSV. It's just a regular comma separated value file. Click there, open it, and it's going to give you this menu where you can fix if your north is not your y's, or your east is not your x's, but everything it seems to be okay. Click OK. Then it will import the points there. Now you go, you what you need now is a boundary outline. So you go to outlines, and then add with the pencil, you just create an automatic one. The computer is gonna go around the points. It's gonna generate an automatic boundary outline. So you click OK, and then apply, and then OK. And there you have it. You have your pile there that it looks very nice. And now you have your surface of the pile is being the existing. Now it's just a matter of creating a proposed surface with a flat platform. Let's just say here, there, there, and there. Then click enter and then give it 0, and it's going to give you the volume for it here. You see that it's 8,879.47 cubic yards, and that comes from that calculation between two surfaces, one being the bottom piece and then the other one being the actual pile. Let's use some other methods to import information besides comma separated values. I'm gonna give you a way to import a DXF, and then I'm gonna tell you how to use a drone image to generate the same pile. Okay, let's now import a DXF file. Same thing, go to this little plus, feature surface. Now we're gonna import contour lines. So you go there, and then you go to the plus sign with a little sheet to import the actual file. I have a DXF file here with contour lines. I know there's a contour that is I think is number 22 is having some issues around here, but we can fix it later. Go to OK, and it's gonna import all of them there. Then obviously we need a boundary outline too, so go to there, then create one automatically. Okay, and let's just try it right now. And it's gonna give me this error. So this item 37, contour elevation 23, is kind of intersecting these other three lines. So I know where it is, and it happened to me. So we can just go like this, go to 37. And what's causing the problem is that it's actually a closed polyline. So we just click there and then apply, and it's gonna generate the same triangulation for it. Once it's done, you just click OK, and it's there. You have it. You have your pile generated out of a DXF. Now let me show you how you can use a drone image from the cheapest drone you may buy to generate that same pile. The process is a little bit different. Now you have to go to plans and then add image or PDF file. I have the sample image here, and there's one thing you need to do with it is to mark some points with a given distance in the real world, and then you take the picture. So I know from this point to this point is 116. So now what you need to do is you need to scale it You click here on scale, then you go down there, you zoom in, you click there, and then you click right about there. Give it the length, 116 feet. You click OK. And then you have your plan ready to, I mean your image ready to be traced. So you click apply and then okay. And then there you have it. With this method, obviously you need to know the height of the pile. So let's assume that we know them. So what you do is you create that a surface. First, you're gonna use a contour line with elevation 0 around the base of the pile. So you go contour and then click on the pencil, and then it's obviously asking you to start tracing. So we go like this, click there, 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 and then you just click around. Yeah, just do it roughly for now. You click around the base of the pile. You need to go in. Same thing here. Go around. Then, once you're done, you click there. You don't even need to close it because it gives you the option. So you just hit enter, and then it's gonna ask you for the level. So we're gonna say 0, and then click here on close, and then finish. So that's our contour line for the base of the pile. We can, if this was a contour line drawing for the piles, you just keep tracing one around and then two and then three, four, five, all the way up. So now what we're going to use is a feature called break lines. Break lines are 3D polylines basically. So you specify an elevation for the point you're marking in X and Y, and then you give it an elevation. So we're gonna add a break line, same thing, break lines, little pencil, and then draw, and then define levels. Now I know that this line, the one I just traced, is actually 0, so let's start there. Something close, you don't really need to be right there. So close there. And then give it elevation 0, then hit enter, and then zoom out, and maybe here you know the height, so click there and then give it elevation 10. And then if you don't know the elevation, just hit enter and leave it like that. The computer is gonna take care of it. So I don't know the elevation for this one, but I know the elevation here that it just happened to be 20, then enter, and then click there. That's another 20. There, that's maybe 25. And then you just 25. Then click 25. Then click there, and then type 25 also for the elevation. And then click there, and then click 25. Just keep doing it till you're done with the high point of the pile, 25. I'm just gonna hit enter, enter there, click there, enter, click there, enter. Then maybe click here and make it 25. And then let's go down, enter, enter, enter. Maybe make this one here 10. And then obviously it goes down to 0 here. So it goes down to 0. I click there and then 0. And then back up to there to be a 10. And then go down here to be at 0. Oh, I forgot. You click there and then complete. You don't close it, just leave it like that and then click finish. Then you have your break line for the top of the pile, and we have a contour line for the bottom of the pile. So Obviously, with this one too, you're going to need a boundary outline. Same thing, click on the pencil, automatic, okay, and there's the outline. So you just need to click on apply and okay it. And it's going to generate it. You don't see it here because it's in 2D. So we go to the 3D view, and there you have it. There's your pile again. That's this method. You can use any image, any PDF file. You can use contour drawings, and even as we did it with just an image in a given distance, you can, as you can see, you can generate the piles too. Well, I think that's all for now. Again, this is Rigo, and thank you for your time.